So now we will discuss the question paper. Okay. So children, first of all, first one, it was a passage. See, your question paper is equally divided into four parts. 20 marks that of reading, 20 marks that of writing, 20 marks that of grammar, and 20 marks that of literature. Grammar will remain the same for final exam also. Annual exam also, the same grammar will remain. For annual exam also, the same writing section will remain. Writing section will remain the same, grammar will remain the same. Okay, so you can improve where you are having the problems. Then regarding reading, reading passage will also be that of the same nature, of the same type. Okay. So total. Don't go for this one and this one. Look, what is the total of this? Okay, so first it is read the passage given. A passage is given. What it is about? See, regarding the passage, first of all, you should read it. If you are going for that, we will go for the questions directly and we will get answer that you can't. First thing is that you should go through the passage at least twice. Then questions, and then again it is required to go for the passage. Okay, so it is on June 24th, 1859, Emperor Napoleon III and French Joseph I were engaged in the Battle of Solferino, commanding a combined total of about 270,000 troops onto the field for a single day of battle. Okay, on this day, they were there for the battle nearly 40,000 were dead, injured or missing, and many of them were simply left to die on the battlefield. Later, spectators crowded the field looking for loved ones, searching for items they could sell, or for simply taking in the horrors of the battle, a Swiss businessman and a social activist. Okay, so this is a Swiss businessman and social activist, Jean Henry Don, who was traveling in Solferino, witnessed all this. Now, who witnessed this? Clearly, it is given. Clearly, it is given who? Jean Henry Donet. Now, second, Jean Henry Donet witnessed the activities of war as well as the countries not prepared or equipped to ease the suffering of those who had been injured in the Battle of Solferino. Donet organized a group of volunteers to help bring water and food to the injured, to assist with medical treatment or write letters to the families of those who were dying, and he urged the public to create an organization which would assist the wounded regardless of which side they fought for during times of war. This man, he decided to do what? He decided to help everyone regardless of which side he belonged to. Casualties happened during the war, those who wounded during the war. Okay, who? Henry Donet. Now, after that moment, he wrote the book, A Memory of Solferino, which urged the public to create an organization which would assist the wounded regardless of which side they fought for during times of war. What kind of organization he decided to create? An organization which will help to the wounded. During the war, his writing inspired countless others to rally behind him in the creation of the International Federation of the Red Cross. And this is how the International Federation of Red Cross was formed. And what was its task? To help all those who suffered during the war. The modern day Red Cross began by devoting itself largely to the disaster relief and epidemic treatment. To what it is? To disaster relief and epidemic. This effort continues to this day. One of the easiest way you can help the Red Cross is to make sure you are able to donate blood and make an appointment at the Red Cross website. Okay, so modern Red Cross, what it is doing? Donate blood. It is coming, helping in epidemic, helping in disaster. Okay, one question was there. What modern, out of the following, which task is not done by the modern Red Cross? So one option, writing letters. So of course it is regarding writing letters, so that you have to opt for. Many of you have opted blood donation. Now blood donation is very much there. Every now and then you find there in the newspaper that blood donated blood, okay, under the Red Cross banner. But donating blood is not the only way you can help out. The Red Cross also encourages donating your time if you can. This is what the Red Cross wants everyone to know. So first of all, what is required from you? You should understand the unseen faces, what it is. Then you should go for the questions. At least two times you should understand it. Then questions you have observed. It is not the earlier way style of questions. The style of questions has been changed. And it is checking your understanding and the knowledge, application-based knowledge. So what is the correct order of the information given below? Now, regarding the passage, what is the correct order of the information? It is not the direct question. It is the correct order of the information. So the informations are given, then the orders of the information are given. For example, in first it is given fourth, third, second, first, second it is given first, will first, second, third, fourth. So likewise, orders are given. And what you have to identify, you have to identify the correct order. And how you will be able to do that? Again, you have to go back to the passage. And you have to identify, yes, this is coming first, this is coming second, this is coming third, this is, okay. And then you match the option that is matching with your list. Okay, so the correct order is, first of all, Emperor Napoleon III and the French Joseph first fought the battle. It is very much given in the first line or not? It's given. So this is your first. Then it is Donet traveled in Solferino. This will come second. Then Donet organized a camp of volunteers. And then the book, A Memory of Solferino, was written. This is the, and you will find all these there in the successive paragraphs. Right or wrong? So this is requiring what? Effort from your side, rather than directly jumping. Okay, that I will do this, I will do that, or this is the thing. It is requiring what? It is requiring effort. That again, you should go through each and everything. Okay, and you should check what is the correct option. So one type of question, what kind of question are questions are coming? That from the given passage, correct order may be asked. That what is the correct order of the happenings? What is the correct sequence? Is it clear to you? So that you have to, need not to panic. You just, you check it, that what is the correct sequence of the events. In the lessons also, when we discuss, we find that you now arrange the correct sequence. Then the writer of A Memory of Solferino was, it's very simple, the paragraph, I wrote the book, so no one should have done any kind of mistake in it. Then the modern day Red Cross doesn't deal with modern day Red. It is given about the earlier Red Cross. In earlier Red Cross, it is clearly mentioned that it used to write letters. But here, it is given blood donation, epidemic treatment, disaster relief. Disaster relief and epidemic treatment, they are in a single line. Okay, so some of those who only read the two and then they jumped, that only disaster's name is given, epidemic's name is given, blood donation is not so. The correct answer is what? To jump for. But what is required from your side? It's required that you should go through. In the next line, it is given that if you want to help, you can donate. That means that it is also one of the activity. And writing letters is not written anywhere. So what is the correct answer?
Writing letters.
Writing a book. Actually, writing letters also, it's not. It's given writing a book. And nowhere in the passage a reference is coming regarding writing a book. Then the most appropriate subheading of para 2. What is the subheading for para 2? Para 2, it begins with Jane Henry Donet. Okay, so what is the appropriate subheading? How International Federation of Red Cross was evolved, function of Red Cross, the contribution of Jane Henry Donet, the battle. The paragraph is beginning with whose name?
Jane Henry.
So that is, it is regarding about his contribution. And what his contribution, he helped during the war, those who wounded. And he formed the organization that is the Red Cross. Okay. Then, the aid provided by Don's volunteer during the battle of Solferino war. What aid he provided? Again, it is given a number of, again, four options are given. Then it is given. Aids mentioned in 1 and 2. As mentioned in line 1, 2 and 3. So you have to select. First, to help bring water and food to the injured. Second, to assist with the medical treatment. Third, to write a book. Fourth, to give relief in epidemic. Okay, so what is the correct option? The correct option is, first, it is to help bring water and food to the injured. And second, to assist with medical treatment. First and second. Nowhere it is to write a book and to give relief in epidemic. Okay, it is regarding that particular war it is. Then, fourth, this F, find the word from the passage which means the same as killing, massacre, slaughter, so atrocities. Then, how can you personally be a part of Red Cross? By donating blood and by donating your time. Then who was Henry Donet? A number of things are given up about him. He was the person who formed the Red Cross. Okay, he was a Swiss businessman and volunteer and like that. Number of things. So this is what passage number one is. What it required from you? A deep understanding. And how you answered that means your first hand reading, but first hand reading will not serve the purpose. What is required? Thorough understanding of the passage is required. Then the second children, it is regarding read the passage given below. The window offered a view of the house opposite. The two families did not speak to each other because of a property dispute. One day, Ruchira's textbooks lay untouched. Are you paying attention? Which organization has been talked about in the passage? Stand up. The problem is that you people don't pay attention when something is discussed. Which organization has been talked about in passage number one? People don't pay attention. That is the big problem. First thing is that you pay attention when things remain discussed there in the class. And once you pay attention, you will get everything. Not listen in the class, you will not pay attention, you will not get anything. So the window offered a view of the house opposite. The two families did not speak to each other because of a property dispute. One day, Ruchira's textbooks lay untouched as the young girl's gaze was on the happenings in the house opposite. There were two new faces in the neighboring household, that of an elderly widow and a girl aged 16. Some of you have written, there were only two new faces in the house. You will not get any marks. Clear cut it is written what it is written, that an elderly widow and a girl aged 16. That is to be mentioned. So this is what you should not jump, rather than you should completely find out that what is asked from you and what you are supposed to write. Sometimes the elderly lady would sit by the window doing the young girl's hair. On other days, she was absent. Now, the young neighbor's daily routine could be seen through the window. The question is there that of 2 marks. What was the daily routine? So clearly, you are getting an answer that what was the daily routine? The new young girl's daily routine could be seen through the window. She cleaned the rice paddy, split nuts, put the cushions in the sun to air them. In the afternoons, while the men were all at work, some of the women slept and others played cards. The girl sat on the terrace and read. Sometimes she wrote. One day there was a hindrance. She was writing when the elderly woman snatched the unfinished letter from her hands. Thereafter, the girl was not to be seen on the terrace. Sometimes during the day, sounds came from the house indicating that a massive argument was going on inside. What was the girl's task that is given? What she used to do? What in the afternoons people they used to do? What was the favorite task of the girl she used to write? And what she was writing that was snatched. It means what her writing things was liked by the family members or not. Not again, it's given that arguments used to be there. A few days passed. One evening, Ruchira noticed the girl standing on the terrace in tears. The evening prayers was in progress. As she did daily, the girl bowed several times in prayer. Then she went downstairs. Evening prayers, the girl bowed and downstairs. Okay. That night, Ruchira wrote a letter. Ruchira wrote a letter to whom? Ruchira wrote a letter to this girl. She went out and posted it that very instant. But as she lay in the bed that night, she prayed fervently that her offer of friendship, it's given her offer of friendship. And it's also given in the question that why she wrote the letter just for offering her friendship. Okay. Ruchira then left for Madhupur and returned because it was time for college to start. She found the house opposite in darkness, locked. They had left. The girl had left from there. Okay. Now when she stepped into the room, she found the desk piled with letters. One had a local stamp with her name and address in unfamiliar handwriting. She quickly read it. They continued to write to each other for the next 20 years. And then she got a letter from that girl. Who received the letter? Ruchira. Now see, children, the questions. On the basis of your reading of the above passage, choose the appropriate answers. Why did Ruchira write a letter to her neighbor? Now it's clear to you why Ruchira. Option A, she wanted to offer her help. Option B, she wanted to offer her friendship. Okay, so option B is correct. It's clearly given there in the passage or not. So those who have done wrong, it is only and only because you have not gone through completely through there. You have not given ample time, sufficient time. You have not tried the best attempt from your side. Which of the following can be said about Ruchira? Which of the following can be said about Ruchira? A number of things are given. And then out of these, how you have to select answer? Only second, both one and two, only third, all of these. Likewise. So you should go through all these things. Some of them, some of you have considered only these as options and you have written second, third as your answers. Okay, so answers is to be selected from where? From these, only second, both one and second, only third, from this. Okay, so first it is given, she used to spy on her neighbor's house. Was this work done by Ruchira? She used to spy. No, her intention was not like that. Then she was at home because she was studying. Why Ruchira was at home? Because she was studying. Clearly it is given. So your answer is only second. Then third it is given, she did not speak to the neighbors because they did not have own property. Because they were not having, no such mention is given there in the passage. Then none of this. So your answer is Your answer is only second. That is, she was at home because she was studying. Then, next question. How did the new young neighbor spend her days? How did the new neighbor spend her days? First, she was busy writing letters to Ruchira. No. No friendship was there in that up to that time. Second, she used to daydream about the past experience. Daydream. And to sit like this and think. Was this done? No. Then she would go to bury. She would go to buy grocery. No. She spent time learning to read and write.
Yes.
Yeah. It's given that she used to write. It's coming or not? So what should have been your answer? Okay, but most of you have committed mistakes while answering passage 1 and 2. It means you have not focused on, you have not spent enough time. What was major argument in the house about? What was the argument about A? There were too many people living there, which resulted in the argument. There were too many. How many people were there? Two. So, no question of too many people. Second, the young girl was insisting on attending college. No reference of college is there. Third, the young girl had been wasting her time in writing and reading instead of working. Yes, it's given that in the afternoons, what she used to do, she used to write. Then, the old woman did not guard the young girl closely. So, answer third is correct. Then, which of the following is true in context to the passage? Which of the following is true? Four options are given, out of which is the true? In regard to the passage, first, the young girl liked playing with other children. No reference is given. Second, only two letters were exchanged between the two girls. No reference is given. Only it is given that
they were talking.
Okay. She quickly read it. They continued to write each other for the next 20 years. They continued to write each other for next 20 years. So there is no question of only two letters. Then the afternoon was a time to relax for everyone. Yes. How relax? Someone used to play
cards.
And someone used to. So it is the time for
rest.
It is given or not? Why did Ruchira wish that the letter would not reach its destination? Why at the later end she decided that the letter should not reach to its destination? When she came back from Madhupura, she thought that the letter should not reach to its destination. One, she was going away and would not be able to see if her neighbor was glad to receive it. Then she was afraid that it would lead to a quarrel between the two families. This could be. Then she was afraid that her neighbor would be angry. You know, she thought that it may lead to quarrel. Then second, she was afraid that her neighbor would be angry. This might be. And fourth, none of these. So option only one is correct. Then only third is correct. Only second and third is correct. All of these. So which is the correct answer? Second and third. Then who were Ruchira's new neighbors? Who were Ruchira's new neighbors? It's clearly given there or not? A girl's. You are getting the answer now? And how you came to know? When you have read the essays. What were the daily course of the young neighbor? What were the daily course of the young neighbor? Means daily work. What was the daily work of the young neighbor? So that it's given what she used to do. So, dear students, this is what regarding passage 1 and 2. Now you have understood it or not? Now I think you can tell the details about the passage. So what is required to read each and everything properly? To pay your attention. See, what you will get that you will do the passage quickly. Okay, you will not devote much time to the passage. But in this, what will happen? Your answers will be wrong when you will not pay proper attention, what will be the result? Your answers may not be correct. Okay. So you should spend enough time. You should read it well. You should understand the question well. Again, you should go and find it there in the. So first, at least one or two times reading that of the passage, then go to the question, then again search your answer. So some time needs to be spent on that. Otherwise, the result will be you will get nothing. Then children, using the information below, write a bio script that of Mother Teresa. I also gave you a reference that it could be from for example, Mother Teresa, Virat Kohli, Sachin Tendulkar, any politician, likewise. So then if not, you have not prepared this one, then it is given you are Amita, the school sports in charge. Likewise, we used to do the notices. You are sports in charge, you are CCA in charge. And what has been given? Your school is a DAV public school, Pritampura, New Delhi. Write a notice about the upcoming annual sports meet to be held. I told you clearly that what is to be written at the top, name of the school, then notice, date, then name of the event sports meet. This is to inform all the students that our school is going to organize a sports meet on this date. Okay, all the students are informed to attend. Is it clear to you? So this problem occurs when you don't listen to the teacher, when you don't pay attention. Then ultimately, who will be the loser? You will be. If you'll pay attention, you will gain everything. If you'll not listen, if you'll not pay attention, then you will not be able to score. Okay, children, so pay attention in the class, listen to the teacher, okay, and then what is required, then do your homework. What discussed in the class, you should revise, and then if there remains any doubt, you should ask there in the next class. But no attempt, no gain. No hard work, no gain. If you do hard work, you will get everything. But without hard work, you will get nothing. Is it clear to you or not? So now it depends upon you what you want. If you want to score good marks, then you have to do a lot of hard work. You have to listen to the teacher. You have to do your work in time. Okay, you have to do revision at home. And next day, you have to ask about your problems. Then next it is regarding article writing. Okay, we have discussed regarding article writing, and the very next is regarding story. So remaining things we will discuss there in the next class. Okay, now it is the time for